wondering how to get into the market when there's so much competition? We've got some insider tips. If somebody doesn't give you a multiple offer form, but an agent is telling you there are multiple offers, does that mean there's not?
No, not necessarily.
Okay.
Multiple offer form is best practice. It makes it a fair level playing field for everybody out there. And it basically gives them fair warning to say, hey, there's other offers out there. Put your best foot forward.
You come back with your absolute best offer.
Yep.
You don't muck around.
Don't muck around. Don't leave anything in the tank because you're going to get one opportunity and that's it on your multiple offer form. There's a couple of tricks that you can do. Don't go up in multiples of fives and tens. Say, for instance, your walk away is on that property, 650,000. Mm-hmm. Ask yourself the question, if the next highest person on that property is at 651, would I go to 652 in order to be able to secure it? And if you would, well, 652 is your number. Keep working that process through your head until you go, you know what, at that point, I'm out. I'm not going to pay any more for that particular property. I'm done and dusted. If I miss it by $1,000, I'm happy. There's another little secret trick that you can do. Put a week's wages on top of that last figure. What it will do is it will make your number unique to you. Now, I've had situations where I've had 13 people trying to buy the one property, and the difference between the first person that missed out and the person that actually secured the property was $350.
Oh, ouch.
Okay.
Yeah.
The person that secured that property was the person that took my advice and put a week's wages on top of their walk away figure.
This is good stuff.
And if it's meant to be, it's meant to be.
Yeah.